virtual reality has been described as the ultimate medium in the sense that it can really simulate, at least in theory, all the other mediums.
If you look at the majority of virtual reality experiences that are publicly available, we could argue that most of them are for entertainment. Most of them are for someone to escape reality, which makes sense because sometimes it can be difficult to be in this reality. It gives immersants or users an opportunity to have fun and explore games or explore different types of experiences that they might not be able to in the real world. So the question of how do we design a course to inspire students to create different types of VR experiences beyond just entertainment-based, experiences that have the potential to be transformational. Fantastic question. And that is the question that we hold over the entire course.
Eventually, right? Yes. But you're going in one world.
Yeah.
So one person at a time.
Yeah.
Right.
The A and the B, C, they both take 20 minutes, and we're going to see
each other. We basically redesigned the course from scratch. And the idea is really that in the context of using emerging technologies, right now, virtual reality in a positive context. So we really challenge people to do something meaningful with it.
But what we wanted to do is we wanted to have more of an intention of how can the VR experience add to social goodness or social good. We don't want to direct the students exactly what to do. We want to give them the tools, and one of those tools is self-reflection and reflecting on their own ideas.
So when we ask them to do projects, we really ask them first, what do you care about? Why do you want to do this? What does it mean for you? What does for good even mean for you?
Our project is called Restless Sleep. So what our project about is about a coma experience. A lot of people think that coma patients have no relation or like contact with the outside world. But in reality, they are. In their mind, they are trying to interact with the outside world, even though they don't show any movements. The reason that we think our project is under VR for good is it creates empathy towards the coma patients or even any other patients in general. Because not a lot of people know how the patients are being treated, and they could be mistreated, and a lot of these cases go unnoticed. And by doing this VR, I think people can get more empathy towards the patients.
So there's no simple recipes for creating experiences that work. Otherwise, everybody would create them. You can't just throw people into VR and expect that they're suddenly immersed and present and so on, and then switch it off afterwards, and then they're changed happily after.
It's your responsibility to guide the user through a story that's going to engage them, that's going to captivate them. You're also responsible for drawing their attention where they want to go.
We want to get this concept and give it to the users, and we combine this into a pre and post experience where we have like a setup of a hospital setting and doctors and nurses so that the users will feel like totally immersed, and they will feel like, oh, this is like a hospital and this is what the coma patients are going through. I think it is necessary for our project to use a VR because the very main thing about the VR is like it can create a personal space. Normally in 2D screens or when you watch movies, you will be just watching what the director is showing or what the cameraman is showing to you. By using a VR, you have a 360 degree of movement and you really feel you are in that environment. And also because there is like a physical space in the VR that you can't achieve with any other medium.
Of course, technology isn't quite there yet, but I think what we're trying to do in this course is to really think about where it can go in 5, 10, 20, 50 years. Just imagine what might be possible then.